Many of us just went through a stretch of 2 weeks without measurable rain. And in fact, for some, the dry spell is ongoing. And although we've all lived through such dry periods, many people have said to me that it seems like an unusual time of year for it to happen. Well, here's a look at the last time before this month when there was a stretch of 14 or more days with no measurable precipitation that included at least a week in May for 5 different locations spread across the state. For most, you have to go back at least 15 years to find such a stretch, and even in Pittsburgh, it's been almost a decade. So if you feel like we haven't had a long dry spell at this time of the year for a while, you're right. What about the longest stretches without measurable precipitation in the last 100 years? Well, here they are, all in the range 25 to 30 days. At Philadelphia, Scranton, and State College, the record dry stretch was in the mid-1960s, which was a time of severe drought in the Northeast. All of these dry periods are generally in September and October, and in fact, autumn historically is the season when long dry stretches are most likely. Now, here's the total number of long dry stretches, which I define as 14 or more days without measurable precipitation over the last 100 years at each place. Philadelphia really stands out, basically double the other places, averaging one long dry stretch per year. This is related to the predominant westerly flow over the state that downslopes off the Appalachians, making long dry spells more likely southeast of the mountains. By the way, Harrisburg and Reading have had close to 100 long dry stretches, and Allentown near 90. So being southeast of the mountains really makes a difference in this regard. Finally, let's check how these long dry stretches are spread across the calendar by month. Here's Philadelphia. October has the most, with August, September, and November kind of a second tier, and just 5 in May, so the recent stretch is unusual. Here's the same chart for State College, representing the middle of the state. The total number of dry stretches is about half that in Philadelphia, but the peak is still in fall, in September, and August, October, and November round out the top 4 months, just as in Philadelphia. If we head west to Pittsburgh, September and October really stand out. In fact, there have been more long dry stretches in those 2 months in Pittsburgh than all other months combined. And they're almost unheard of from November to March. We see that again in Erie, where only one long dry stretch has occurred from November to March in the last 100 years, basically because the lake effect is so effective at making precipitation in those months. But in the warm season, the relatively cool lake has the opposite effect. It stabilizes the lower atmosphere and reduces the risk of precipitation near the lake. Thus, the most likely months to get long dry stretches in Erie are actually June and July, though there's still a secondary peak in early autumn. The blocking pattern that produced our recent dry spell is breaking down. What does that mean for the extended forecast? Stay tuned. It's next.